Hello friends, now we are discussing about the chapter 2, that is crop water requirement and reservoir planning. The weightage given to this chapter is 16 marks. Here are the syllabus contents which includes in chapter 2 crop water requirement, in that the cropping seasons, crop period, base period, duty, delta, CCA means culturable command area, and GCA means gross command area. After that, intensity of irrigation, factors affecting the duty, and problems on water requirement and capacity of canal. Next, the methods of application of irrigation water and its assessment, surveys for irrigation project and data collection for irrigation project, then area capacity curve, after that silting of reservoir means in that the rate of silting, factors affecting silting and control measures, and control levels in reservoir. So this is the syllabus contained in chapter 2, crop water requirement and reservoir planning. So let's start from the first topic, that is water requirement. So this water requirement, it is the amount of water required by a crop in its whole production period. Okay, and the different crops grows in different seasons, and each crop requires different quantity of water. That's why the water amount of water required by crop in its full production period, from the time it is sown till its maturity, the water requirement may vary with different crops at different places of the country, and the water requirement depends upon the following factors: climate, next is type of soil, method of cultivation, and rainfall. So in climate, whether the climate is dry or cold, or sometimes it is polar, so depends upon the climate condition the water requirement may vary. Next is type of soil. So whether the soil is sandy or clay, or sometimes it may be silt soil, so depending upon that the water requirement given to the crop it may vary. Next is third one factor is method of cultivation. So in that again, whether that cultivation method is extensive or intensive, this is also a main factor which depends upon the water requirement. Directly method of cultivation directly affects the water requirement. And last one is rainfall. So how much rainfall, and whether the rainfall is conventional or there is no rainfall, depends upon that the water requirement may vary. Next is crop seasons. So from the agricultural point of view, there are mainly two cropping seasons. First one is kharif or summer crops, and second is rabi or winter crops. So in this kharif crops are also called as summer crops, and the kharif crops requires more water than rabi crops, and which includes rice, bajra, jawar, maize, cotton, tobacco, etc. So these are the crops in kharif season. Second type is rabi or winter crops. So rabi crops are also called as winter crops, and for example, grams, mustard, linseed, potatoes, wheats, all are the winter crops or rabi crops. Next is cropping seasons and crops in Maharashtra. So here is a table which shows the cropping seasons and commonly common crops in Maharashtra. So let's see first that is kharif season. So that period for kharif season is from 15 June to 14 October, and the best period is 123 days. And in kharif season, the weather is warm or humid, and rice, jawar, cotton, tur, groundnut, urid, these are the common crops which are taken in kharif season. Likewise, second is rabi season. So the period is from 15 October to 14 February, and base period given to this rabi season is 122 days. The climate is or weather for rabi season is either cool or dry, and the common crops taken in rabi seasons are wheat, gram, linseed, etc. After that, for hot weather, the period is from 15 February to 14 June. The best period is 120 days, and the climate becomes hot or dry, and common crops in hot weather includes only irrigated crops like vegetables, rice, etc. After that, 8 monthly season. For 8 monthly season, the period is from 15 June to 14 February, and the base period is 245 days, and the common crops which are taken in 8 monthly season, they are tobacco, cotton, tur, groundnut, etc. And last is for annual season, the period is from 15 June to 14 June next year, means the best period is 365 days. And the annual and the common crops which are taken in annual season is sugarcane and orchard, etc. Next point is important definitions. So let's see one by one. First, crop season, crop period. So it is that period that crop takes from the instant of its sowing to that of its harvest, means crop period, and it is expressed in days. Second is base period. It is denoted by capital B, and it is the period from first watering before sowing to the last watering before harvesting. And this base period is also expressed in number of days. Okay, next is duty. It is expressed as a capital D, and it is the area in hectares irrigated by 1 cubic per meter per second of water flowing continuously for the base period for a particular crop. Next is delta. So delta means it is the total depth of water required by a crop during the entire period of crop. For the complete maturity of crops, and it is denoted by the symbol delta, and it is expressed in centimeter. Next is average duty. The average duty means it is the flow duty calculated at the beginning of type of canal or main canal for a small project, and it is always less than duty because it takes all types of losses in account, or all type of losses are considered. That's why the average duty is always less than duty. Next is gross duty or tank duty. So the gross duty means it is the area under different crops irrigated by 1 million cubic meters of stored in a tank in 1 year, means called as tank duty or gross duty. Next is crop rotation. So what is crop rotation? It has been observed that if same crop is sown again and again, then the yield gets decreased or reduced. This is mainly due to the reason that the crop requires particular nutrients and the soil is deficient in these after that crop, and hence to maintain that fertility of soil, there is a change in crop after every season on a particular land to maintain the fertility of soil. This is called as rotation of crop, and the main advantage of crop rotation is it helps in proper use of land resources, and it also increases the fertility of soil. So generally the crop rotation is for generally the usual crop rotation followed is jawar, gram and fallow. Second is wheat, jawar and gram. Next is cotton, jawar, groundnut, or cotton, wheat and gram. After that, the crop rotation is rice and gram. So these are the alternate crops which are grown in with crop rotation. Next is seasonal duty. It is also called as flow duty, and it is the average duty for all the crops usually sown during the crop season. In this type of duty, all the transit losses are taken into consideration, and these are mainly used for the water planning. Next is core water. So core water is the first water applied to the crop after sowing the crop. This water must be applied within a fixed limited period. Next is core water. So this core water is the first water applied to the crop after sowing the crop. This water must be applied within the fixed limited period, and this period is called as core period, and the depth of water applied for this core water is called as core depth. Next is crop ratio. So it is the ratio of proposed areas under the crop of two main seasons, that is Kharif and Rabi seasons. It is called as crop ratio, and the area to be irrigated for Rabi crop is more than that of for Kharif crop. Next is Palau irrigation. So sometimes it is observed that in the initial stages before the crop is sown, the land is very dry, So in such cases, the soil is moistened with water so as to help in sowing. This is called as pallav irrigation. Okay. Next is cash crops. A cash crop is a crop which cannot be consumed directly by the cultivators, but which has to in cash in market for processing. These crops are called as cash crops. For example, tea, cotton, tobacco, sugarcane. So these are the examples of cash crops. Next is intensity of irrigation. So it is the ratio of area irrigated per season to the total irrigable area. This is called as intensity of irrigation. Next is time factor. The time factor is the ratio of number of days canal has actually run to the number of days of irrigation period. Means time factor. And last is capacity factor. It is a ratio of mean supply discharge to the full capacity discharge, means capacity factors. So these are some technical terms which are used in crop water requirement. Thank you. Hope you understand this video. Thank you.